Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about agonists, ligands that cause an increase in response from a receptor. Receptors are proteins, but receptors are very different from enzymes. Some can mimic enzymes and catalyze reactions. Others are able to turn on or off signaling pathways. Often, the receptors communicate signals across a membrane. Turning on or off a receptor changes a receptor's response. Molecules that bind receptors are called ligands. Receptors are named after their natural ligand in the body. And the natural ligand for a receptor is called the endogenous ligand. Unnatural ligands, like most drugs, are called exogenous ligands. So most drugs fall into this category. Agonists are ligands that bind to a receptor and turn on a pathway and cause some sort of biological response. Below is a curve for a full agonist. Full agonists bind, and once they reach a high enough concentration on the x-axis, can achieve a full response, 100% or 1 on the y-axis. Activity curves for receptors are normally plotted as shown. The response is the y-axis, listed as a ratio of E to Emax, or sometimes just E. E stands for response or effect. The log of the ligand concentration is the x-axis. The result is a sigmoid-shaped curve. The inflection point of the curve occurs at 50% response and at an x-value called EC50. In this case, it's log EC50. This is the concentration required for 50% or 0.5 effect or response. This is sometimes also called KD. So EC50 equals KD. And KD is the dissociation equilibrium constant for the agonist ligand and its receptor. EC50 and KD are both potency measures. The lower the value, the higher the potency of the ligand. Not all agonists are full agonists. Some agonists bind and cause less than a full response. An example is the blue line. This is a partial agonist. Its max response is 40% or 0.4. Partial agonists can be really weak, or almost as strong as a full agonist. The potency of a partial agonist is still called an EC50 and is measured at the inflection point, which will be 1/2 of the partial agonist maximum response, about 0.2 for this example. The potency is still called an EC50. In this case, it's logarithmic, so it's log EC50. Less common are superagonists. The red line is a superagonist. Superagonists are able to cause a response even greater than the endogenous ligand, greater than 100%, and all the way up to 140% or 1.4 in this case. We still measure potency at the inflection point, which occurs at about 0.7. For this ligand, it is still called the EC50, log EC50 in this case, even though it occurs above 50% response. These are the agonists: full agonists, partial agonists, and superagonists. As always, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, or give feedback below. Take care.